Speak to you until I make you smile. You see, it's incredible when you respond that way. I've been waiting to get close enough to say, search no more, look no further, I've got what you need. Oh, everything you want and everything you need, find it here in me, come. Searching for is here all the time. All your dreams have been answered for in advance. I'm just sitting patiently waiting on my chance. Search no more, oh, look no further. I've got what you need. Everything you want and everything you need, find it here in me, cause
Angela Mara on Premier Gospel Music for Life. We're talking to Reggie Cole about his business. And, you know, Reggie, you said you were successful for a long time. You had a determination. You're raised around your father who showed you how to have integrity, and you've kept that in your business. And then you hit a low point. You lose your money. Your family are away, move away from you. Everything's at that dark space. Tell me what that dark space is like when you think, oh, my God, how do I come up from this?
Yeah, this is apt. This is very apt because here's a dark space, and here's how you come away from it. You read and understand and believe in the story of Joseph. If you read and understand and believe in the story of Joseph, and you're willing to pay the price, because we all have to pay a price, then you will come through. It's as simple as this. In his book, I think I've quoted it in a show that you invited me to speak on before, Steve Covey, The Seven Habits of Highly Effective People. Habit number two is you begin everything with the end in mind. Begin with the end in mind. Now, here's the thing. You need to decide what that end is. You need to see it. And I tell people it's two things. It's like God gives us the answers in nature. If I am with, say, a wife or whatever, and we decide to have children, it's an exciting time. That's the dream. But throughout the pregnancy, it's a struggle. Yep, there's going to be struggles. That's life teaching us. Mm. Even when this dream is born, and that's your kid, if you don't look after that child, you can lose all of that. And that's some people go all the way. They go through the dream, they go through the struggle, and then they get birth of this new tool, and they lose it. Mm. We've seen it with footballers, we've seen it with musicians or whatever, but that's when you realize it's a continuous process, this life. You begin with the end in mind, you got to nurture, you got to be there, you got to pay attention, you got to do what you got to do. But so how I got through it, Andrew, to answer your question specifically, was I knew that was not the way I was going to say goodbye to this world. I wasn't going to go out a loser.
Okay.
And I was determined, so I kept pressing on, and I kept praying, and this is true, I kept praying, and guess what? Bill O'Brien is dead, so is my dad, but God sent me another mentor, in his name, Chris Hughes, sent me another mentor, a multimillionaire. He calls me, He's 69 and he calls me his copycat. He says, your life is my life. Mm-hmm. I've lived this life. And we're totally from different cultures. We don't even speak the same language. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
We're totally different people.
So you think it's really important. I mean, we're talking about mentorship and understanding that having somebody say to you, it is going to be okay, because you need that experience to get to the next stage. But to have that faith and understanding and that belief, because I know for you it's belief in God, it's understanding that this is a journey as opposed to, you know, you're just trying to get to a destination. It's a complete journey of understanding that there are going to be pitfalls, there's going to be understanding, and you might lose things like your family. I mean, that's the hardest thing to say you're going to lose is family, because you can lose houses and cars and come back. But when it's a risk of your family, that must be difficult. And how do you balance life now, Reggie?
Angie, the one thing I do with my ex, you know, as beautiful as she is, the one thing I've done is I make sure that money is not a worry, because that's the big area of people's lives, right? I mean, you can relate, right?
Yeah.
Whenever there's money frustration, it brings it to another level.
Mm.
So I make sure my children have the best that I could give them. But here's another thing that I do, and I struggle to keep a relationship because of this next thing. I spend a lot of time with them. So my free time, holidays. My daughter tells me this, so I'm not saying something my daughter doesn't say, says, Dad, you're just fun to be around.
Mm-hmm.
I make them happy.
Mm-hmm.
You know, because I realize the price that they've paid. They've paid, they were not asked to be born, but all of a sudden now they're growing in different houses and everything else. So I just make it up to them, and geez, what I do.
So tell us about the business that you actually are now. Tell us about buy-to-let cars.
So how buy-to-let cars came about is because when I had my business, you see, out of a negative comes a positive.
Yeah.
When I had the first business, it was based on banks giving the finance loans to people who had credit issues. And what I had to do was to make sure they understood, you know, their obligation. And they decided what sort of vehicle they wanted. And I went out to market and bought the vehicles. And, you know, people were happy. My office was decorated with thank you cards. But then April 15th. 2008 happened. My own world got wind of the credit crunch, and the banks who were supporting those customers pulled out, and my life changed, and I lost everything. So how did buy-to-let cars come about? Buy-to-let cars came about because I decided, right, to do a surgery on why I was broke.
And so far, it's just gone from strength to strength. You've just, I don't know if you want to talk about, you know, how it's moving from strength to strength, but it has grown and you are back in the driver's seat.
Yeah. Angie, I'll tell you exactly, I was given £100,000 in a 3-hour meeting in 2012. And we started the business. Again, for the listeners, you think because you've done it before, so you should know the answer. That's not how it works.
Yeah.
Because I found myself in Buckingham Palace Road with an office that I couldn't afford. And within 3 months, Angie, can you imagine this? Imagine this. You come from the dole queue, and within 3 months, you've blown £100,000, not even spoiling yourself, just on business decisions.
See, that's the thing, isn't it? Just to sum up now, Reggie, that people invest in people. People don't invest in, you know, things. They invest in the person. And what you spoke about at the beginning was about integrity and having that as your character, which is very important, so that you can show your hand and that you'll be able to do business from there. So whatever you bounce back from, people know that it's about who you are. So it's very important for our listeners to hear how important it is to stand on your word. So, you know, Reggie, I know you're somebody that believes in God, you know, that is the core of who you are. And that's important to know, because people sometimes don't think that they can be Christians and do business in the same way. And you know what I mean? Be just as sharp and just as shrewd. Just what I mean? So it's important to know that you can mix it up.
You know what, Angie? The business talks about business. I mean, the Bible talks about business. No other subject. At least 32 times Jesus himself said, do business. But you know what I like? Even sometimes when I'm in church, this thought comes across my mind. And here it is. The Bible says, be a man diligent in his work, he will sit among kings. And yeah. I live that way today.
Thank you, Reggie, for joining us on Premier Gospel Music for Life.
Day is a day of smile. Cause today I got a new leash on life. Today I became wise. Cause I realized I was wasting time. Spent many years living on the surface. Never took the time to go deeper in your service. I know the problem wasn't you, it was me. Every day living my life, trying to be man pleasers. But today now became your day, because my plan became your way.
You listen to Angie Lemar on Premier Gospel Music for Life, and this was our business section show. It's a special. Sometimes we just need to work out how we're going to do things and move forward. Carol, Reggie.
I don't even know what to say. That was absolutely amazing. There were just so many powerful points that came out of there. I loved the fact that he brought in the story of Joseph.
Yeah,
powerful. And we all know the story of Joseph and that whole thing where Joseph had a vision.
Yeah.
And sometimes we have a vision and not realising that it might take time to get to the vision. And that with the whole Joseph story, some people would think that actually that vision really wasn't real. But if we look at the trials and the tribulations that he went through to eventually have that vision come to fruition.
Yeah.
And I think that that's like life, isn't it? That sometimes we have a really great idea or something is that we want to do, but stuff gets in the way and kind of looks as though we're never going to make it.
Yeah.
But I think I love the fact that Reggie talked about passion. He talked about doing something is that you were passionate about.
Yes.
And it's really powerful when is that passion is a driver. It helps you to get up in the morning. It helps you to remember why it is that you can get through the storm and you can kind of get through the rain.
Yeah.
And the key thing as well was when Reggie talked about God's in the center of it.
Yes.
And that if God's in the center of it, then actually there is no way it is that you can fail. And failure is just the other side of the coin of success.
Absolutely.
And that actually, in terms of kind of failure, it's just feedback, really, because we just learn another way not to do something.
And you can get caught up in a rut and think that, oh, God, if I've made that same mistake, then how do I stop making a mistake? And sometimes it's actually not a mistake.
Yeah.
It's timing. As you mentioned about the banks, it's timing.
Yes.
You've done nothing wrong. The first time I met Reggie, he sat me down and said, write it on the on the tablets, basically. So sit there and just write down your vision, how you see it in the next year.
But isn't it interesting?
Powerful vision.
The Bible tells us this, you know, Habakkuk 2:2. Write the vision and make it plain.
Yes.
So the information is there. Mm-hmm. We're just choosing not to listen to it or not to do it. But it's really powerful that someone like Reggie is taking the time to give back.
Yes.
Because it's back to that whole thing about learning, standing on the shoulders of other people and learning from their experience and their mistakes.
Absolutely.
And for them to help us to see the way.
And that's really what it comes down to. So for Angie's Moments, I would just say, really, you know, it's a powerful show today. We've been able to look at some of the mistakes. And sometimes you're watching people and you think that they have got it going on and they don't have downtimes or they don't have pitfalls or they've not come through or things are going wrong and they're just going on. They're keeping it going, keeping it moving. So I really hope that a moment of silence now. For people who think they want to give up, I want you to realize that it's not. Everything that has happened to you is for a reason, for the next stage. It all becomes experience and it all becomes something that you can use for the future of your life. Join us next week on Premier Gospel, thanking Reggie Cole for joining us and also Carol Pike. Carol, give us your website again before we go.
It's Words That Deliver. www.wordsthatdeliver.com.
Words That Deliver. Angie Lemar, see you next week.
When your world seems upside down, you're trying not to frown. When you feel like hope is lost, though you know you paid the cost.
When your life is in despair and you're trying to repair, know that God is on your side and you know you'll make things right.
Your words have no power over me. God has the final say. God has the final say. God has the final say. And you can't control my destiny. God has the final say. God has the final say. God has the final say.
Look up to the sky, there's an answer from above, and it says
Give me the time. Wait, it'll make-